Fine. Now what I'm doing here, the 2000 screen, the 2000 screen, I have maintained select options, and if I click on get data, okay, if I click on get data, then automatically the data is fetching here, okay. And after that one, tabs are coming, tabs also automatically activating. I did not write any code for the activating of tab, okay. So system automatically generated that code, okay. So in the first tab, I want to display header information in the table control. The second tab, I want to display the item information in the table control. Okay. So how can we do that one? So in the 2001, okay. And before that one, in the 2000. So is there any module? Yes, module is available here. Okay, that is okay, fine. And but they are not using any. Okay. Okay, back button functionality they didn't write. I will check it now. Click on save button. This is the PBO. I am taking the PBO include here. Click on OK button. And here back button for back button functionality I am taking. Back button and here back. Okay, back. Double click on it. Here I'm taking the functional type as E because at exit command. Okay, at exit command. For that one, I'm taking E. Click on OK button. Activate it. Fine. So fine, the 2000 screen, if I click on back button, then I want to module back button. Okay, back button at exit command. Okay, I'm taking the first one because I will give something validation for this session score VB, I mean EBELN. Okay, I will give validation at the time. If you are giving any validation, then back button functionality will not work. Okay, that's why I'm taking the back button functionality in a separate module, and I'm giving at exit command for that one. Okay, and I will create that module now. Click on S button. Okay, this is a PAI event, so I'm going for PAI include. And here, if say you come equal to, say you come on back. Okay, if say you come equal to back, then. Program. Okay. So now 2000 screen is completed. Okay, there is no another coding part is pending. Okay, 2000 screen part is completed. Now 2001 will come. Okay, the 2001. Okay, I want to display. One table control. What it is, maybe the name is this one and text is this one, fine. Here I want to display some table control. Okay, table control, but I am not taking table control with wizard I am taking. Means automatically all the code will come here. Okay, automatically all the code will come. Fine, click on this with wizard of table control, drag and drop that one. Drag and drop that. Okay, so automatically something screen is coming here. Okay, click on continue button. So what is the name of the table control? Okay, I am giving EKKO underscore table control. EKKO table control TBC I am giving here. Click on continue button. Okay, dictionary table. What is the internal table you want to take here? Okay, I want to take here ITEKKO. Okay, and the I'm taking this one here ITEKKO. I'm taking the work area name. Workaria name, Workaria TKKO. Okay. So these two things I am taking here. Dictionary table means if you want to take something fields from the table level, direct table level, then we have to select the first one. But I am not selecting the tables. I am not taking the fields from the table level directly. I am taking the fields from the Workaria. Okay, Workaria and internal table. IT AKKO, Workaria AKKO. I have taken here. Unclick on continue button. Okay, so it is showing you. I mean, how many fields in the Workaria AKKO in that structure? 3 fields are available. So how many fields you want to take in this table control? I want to take 3 fields here. Okay, select the 3 fields and click on continue button. Okay, and find no problem. Click on continue button. Okay, scroll down. Okay, scroll down. I want to activate and click on continue button. Okay, and here it is asking you the modules. Okay, the modules include for PBO. I want to give in the PBO only. Okay, and the PAI for PAI only I want. And include for sub program. Okay, for the sub programs, fine, no problem. I mean, I am taking ZMPP7 only. Click on continue button. Click on complete button. See, automatically EBELN, BDAT and Lipner is coming here. Okay, if you double click on it, Workaria EKKO EBELN, automatically the name is coming here. Okay, here also Workaria EKKO BDAT, Workaria EKKO Lipner. If you double click on the table control, automatically horizontal, vertical and multiple single something is selecting here. Okay, and something buttons. Okay, something in next page, before space, last page, first page, like that, something buttons also coming here. Okay, automatically it is coming here. I am not giving anything. Okay, automatically system is generating for that one. And now I will click on back button, save and click on back button. And if you see the flow logic, okay, you see the flow logic of the 2001, automatically code is coming here. I did not write anything. Okay, loop at IT EKKO into Workaria EKKO with control, something is coming, something module end loop. Okay, and here also loop at EKKO IT EKKO something. Okay, automatically all the code is coming. I am not writing anything here. Okay, now I will go for 2003 also. Fine, 2003 came here. Fine, it's good. And 2002, the 2002 also same thing I have to do. Okay, click on layout button here. So here also I want to take the tab 2. In the tab 2, I want to display the table control, right? And here also I am taking table control with wizard only. Okay, table control with wizard and drag and drop here. Okay, drag and drop and click on continue button. The name for the table control is EKPO_TBC. Okay, EKPO_TBC. Click on continue button. Okay, and the internal program name, internal table name is IT EKPO. And the Workaria name is the Workaria EKPO. Click on continue button. Click on continue. Something is happening here. ZMPP7 is in the work list. Activate to make a table available. Okay, fine. Understood. Click on cancel this one. Data will be lost. Okay, fine, no problem. Okay, save it. Click on back button. Double click on the main program. Right click on it and activate it. Because it is asking the activation. It is not activated yet. We have activated like that. It is asking you. Okay, IT EKKO expected something. only one error is coming, and the 280 EKKO expected, not EKKO, not EKKO, 80 EKKO. Let me check that one. Correct only fine. Oh, 1 minute, guys. Something problem is there. I don't know exactly what, where it is coming like that, because it is a standard program, right? I mean, automatically code is generating here, so we have to check where it is coming like that. One minute, guys. Otherwise, I will do one thing. I will remove all the things and I will activate it once again. Is it? So I am not taking these all things here. The PB book. The PA also, I am not taking anything here. Okay, in the layout, I will go to the layout and I will remove all the things here. I mean, I don't want this one. Just right click and delete button. I will create it once again. Click on Flow Logic, save it. And now in the main program also, the code is added here. Okay, we have to remove that one. Okay. Tab one functionality is okay. Subscreen is also okay, fine. And here controls, this is not required now. These all things not required. So automatically code, this code is coming here. Okay, I am not, I don't want to take this one. I am removing all the code here. Delete it. Okay. Now save it and check it and activate it. Is there any problem or not? Right click and activate. Something problem with the display errors. Where is it? Okay, fine. Here also I have to remove it. Sorry. Check it. I'm activating it once again. Fine. Now it's okay. Code. I mean, I will try to add that one more time. The 200 one screen. I will go to the layout tab here. I will drag and drop the table control with wizard here. Okay. And here I am giving something name. This one is EKKO. EKKO underscore TBC. Click on continue button. Click on the internal program table here. And here I am taking IT EKKO. And the work area name is work area EKKO. Click on OK button, continue button. Okay, ZMPP7 is not in the work list or active the, okay, it is not activated at all. Cancel. Yes. It is showing something not activated like that it is showing. Yeah, program is activated. I'm taking one more time tab shift with sorry table control with wizard. EKKO underscore TBC I'm taking here. Click on continue button. The internal table name is ITEKKO. And the work area name is work area EKKO. Click on continue button. And the field names I am selecting all fields I want in this table control. Click on continue button. And click on continue button. Scroll. Click on continue button. Here the modules it is showing you. So this will come in the PBO. And it will come in the AI. Click and continue. Complete. Okay, now it came like this. Save it. Click on back button. Now double click on the main program. Right click and activate it. Errors are problem. It should not come the errors because automatically code is coming here. So it should not come the errors, but it is coming here like that. Describe table at EKKO lines, EKKO, TBC lines. This is correct only. Double click on the main program. We will check that one. Why it is coming like that? We will check that one. Double click on the main program and right click on it and activate it. I think it's completed now. I will go for 200 to screen in the layout tab. And before that one, double click on the main program and right click and activate it. It is must not should, otherwise, it will throw something errors. I will go for 200 to screen. The same thing I am applying here, layout. And here also I am taking the table control with wizard for the VBAP. Click on continue button. The table control name is ekpo_tbc. Click on continue button. The internal table name is IT ekpo. The work area name is work area ekpo. Okay, click on continue button. The field names, I am selecting all the fields here. Click on continue button. Click on continue. And one more time, click on continue. On the modules, modules underscore PBO, and this is underscore PAI. And the sub programs are the same program. Click on continue. Click on continue. And click on complete button. Okay. Now save it. Click on back button. Automatically code is coming here. Automatically code is coming. Now double click on the main program. Right click and activate it. So same thing is coming here. Display errors. Fine. Check it. Now double click on the main program, activate it. So it's completed now. Okay, so 2001, 2002 subscreens, these two are completed. Now I will try to create the transaction code for this one. Transaction code for this one is what the program name? 07, right? I am taking. This is the PO information. Click on OK button. Program name is ZMPP7. The screen number, the first screen is 2000. And select the checkboxes like this. Last three checkboxes, save it. Okay. Now double click on the main program and right click it and activate it. It's activated. Now I will go to the transaction code 07. Click on enter button. Okay, header data and item data, something data is coming. 49, this is the PO number, right? I don't know exactly the PO number, so I'm clicking an F4 button here. ZR0952999. Okay, click on get data button. So something data is coming, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, right? And click on item button. And here also data is coming, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99. Okay. And here a scroll down, right? I will check for that scroll down also. And here, I'm taking, click on get data. Scroll down is not working. Okay, we have to do that scroll down here. Click on back. Back button functionality will work here. Okay, so for the 2001 screen. Okay, for the 2001 screen. So click on layout button here. Okay, this is layout only. Click on back button. And here we have to take some module here. Here describe table only I am taking. Describe table IT ekpo lines lv and square lines I am taking here. Okay, lv and square lines I am taking here, and lv and square lines equal to lv and square lines plus one I am taking. Okay. And the table control name is table control name ekko_tbc table control -lines equal to lv_lines. Okay, this concept I already explained in the last class, right? Same thing I'm applying here, and now what I'm doing, I will declare that one. Okay, LVN square length is there, right? So I will declare that LVN square length now. Data LVN square length type I. Okay. Now double click on the main program and right click and activate it. What is it? Table control name is EKKBTBC only, right? So in the declaration part, how it is coming? Controls, TBST, TabStrip is okay, and some more controls is there. Controls EKKBTBC. This is the correct only. EKKBTBC correct only. Okay, so the declarations are not coming in proper way. That's why it is showing like this type of messages. Okay. So these all are not required to check these all things. Okay. This is for scroll down, top of page, end of page, like that it will come. The logic is coming for that one. Save it. Now double click on the main program. Right click and activate it. Fine, it's working fine now because the declaration parts. So the declarations are coming after end form. Here form end form it is taking here, right? Here the form is there, right? So after end form we should not take any executable line. Okay, so after end form you have to take only form end form only. Okay, if you take any executable line, then any declarations part, then it won't consider. Okay, what happened previously? So the declarations are coming after the end form. That is why it is showing something error message here. Now I will try to activate it and execute the program here. And for EKQ 1 minute, and for EKPU also scroll down is not working, right? Check it. Check it. Fine. Double click on the main program. Right click and activate it. Now I will try to execute the program in separate session. Something 952.05 I'm taking. Click on get data. So 104 is coming, and if you scroll down, I think 105 is not available, so 105 is not coming, but scroll down is working here. Okay, scroll down is working, and I will come to item. So here also up to 104 is coming, 105 is not available. The data is not available in 105, this way it is not coming here. Okay, scroll down is working here. And fine, I will give here one more time. Here I will give 102 only, or 101 I will give. Okay, 101, click on get data. Okay, it is coming up to 101 only. If you click on header data, it is coming up to 101 only. Fine. Now I want to do the validation here. Okay, the purchase document number, I want to do the validation. How can we do the validation part? So validation part of 2003 here, right? So actually the 2003, it won't come here. Sometimes it won't come here. Okay, if you double click on this 2003, so this is a selection screen, right? So automatically something code will come like this. Okay, automatically code will come like this. Sometimes you cannot get 2003 because this is a selection screen. I mean, now you are declaring this one. Okay, selection screen, begin of screen, screen number, a sub screen, like that you are declaring, right? Sometimes it won't come here. Okay, if it is coming, then that's okay, no problem. We will double click on it and we will come to the flow logic and the PAI, the process after input. Here I will take something module validate PO. Okay, validate PO here. If it won't come, okay, if 2003 won't come, then what we have to do? Okay, in the main program, you just write like call screen 2003. Okay, call screen 2003, just double click on it. Okay, it will come like this. Okay, then you have to write the validation part like this. Okay, validation part I'm writing, I mean, I'm taking one module here. Okay, and this is the PAI. Right, I am taking PAI only, and here I will take a select single EVLN from EKO into LVN square EVLN, here EVLN in SN square EVLN. Okay, where SN square EVLN, where EVLN SN square EVLN, if size of C not equal to 0, then I want to display one message, invalid PO type E, and LVN score EVLN, I didn't declare right data, LVN score EVLN type EVLN, save it. Now save it, click on back button. So validation part, I have written the PAI. Okay, validation part, I have written the PAI, the validate is coming here, and click on back button. And once you have written the code, okay, once you have written the code, you just remove this one. Okay, we should not do like that. Okay, we should not write call screen, screen number, that sub screen number, we should not write like that. Okay, so sometimes the screen number won't come here, that sub screen, whatever we have given a selection screen for select options. Okay, that screen number won't come sometimes. So at that time only we have to write here call screen screen number 2003, and we have to double click on that one, and PAA we have to take one module for validation part, and we have to write the code, and we have to remove the call screen here. Okay, we have to remove the call screen. Now save it, double click on the main program and right click and activate it. Fine. Double click on the main program, right click and activate it. Don't worry about this one. So Monday also I will try to explain about this one. I think in today's class it will be a little bit clumsy. I mean, the screens are not clear. I mean, something errors came. What I have done, you don't know exactly. So Monday also I will explain about this one. And something here, one more concept is there, that is the model dialog box. Okay, I didn't explain about this one. Monday I will explain one more time about this one. I mean, table control with wizard and tab strip with wizard and model dialog box. Okay, you don't worry about that one. And right click on it and activate it. I'm trying to execute the program one more time. Okay. And here I'm giving something invalid number. Okay, click on get data. It is showing something invalid view. Okay, I'm giving something number. Click on get data. Okay, so the data is coming like this. Fine. And I will give you one scenario. First of all, I will explain about that one. Where is it? So just try to work on this scenario. I will send you mail this one. Okay, that PDF I will send you mail. So first of all, 2000 screen you have to take. So in this 2000 screen, you have to display something tabs like this. Okay, something buttons. Okay, this is the screen number. This is the screen number. This is for your reference, not for displaying purpose. This is for your reference. 2100, 2210, 2300. These are for your reference. And here you have to display user, and here username, your current username, what it mean, your login ID is there, right? That login ID you have to display here, and date, today's date you want to display here, and exit button should be there. Okay, if I click on this new record button, then 2100 screen will come. Okay, if I click on new payment, then 2200 screen will come. If I click on transaction, 2300 screen will come. If I click on exit button, then total program should execute here, I mean terminate here. And here back button also I want to display. Okay, standard back button. If I click on back button, program will terminate here. Okay, the 2100 customer and vendor, two buttons I'm taking. Okay, if I click on exit button, here total program should total program should terminate here. Okay, if I click on back button, the previous screen 2000, okay, 2000 screen should come. Okay, you just read it, then you can understand this one. Okay, in this screen, if I click on this customer button. Okay, if I click on this customer button, then I want to display this screen. So in this screen, I'm maintaining the data like this: customer name, customer address, customer mobile number, bank account, IFSC code, like that, and submit button. If I click on submit button, then automatically the customer number should generate and save the data with customer number. Customer number is the primary key here. I am not providing any primary key. You have to generate it automatically. You just think about that one. This is an extra functionality. I didn't tell this one till now. Okay, you just think about that one. If I click on submit button, automatically customer number should come, and that customer number plus with this data should save in the table level. If I click on exit button, total program should terminate. If I click on back button, the previous screen should come. Okay, you just read this material, you just read this scenario, and if you have any doubt, then please let me know. Okay, I will send you mail this scenario. Okay. And don't apply any table control with wizard like that, normal only. You have to write the code normally.